Good evening and thank you all for joining us today. My name is Rashmita and I'm the event planner for Microsoft Reactor Bengaluru, India. This session will run over the next 60 minutes, including Q&A. The session is being recorded and will be uploaded to our Reactor YouTube channel. I will share the link to our YouTube channel in the chat section soon. Before we begin, please take a moment to read our code of conduct. We are all here to learn together, so please be respectful of other people's views, understanding of differences, being kind and considerate in the way you engage. The chat will be open throughout and we do encourage you all to participate. Also, please keep your mics muted during the session. I would now like to welcome Kirti, our speaker for today's session. Kirti is an Office Development MVP and a Microsoft certified trainer and has 16 plus years of progressive experience in architect, designing, developing, deployment and administration of SharePoint applications and implementation of business application in client server and distributed environments. But for now, I will hand over to Kirti to begin the session. Over to you, Kirti.
Yeah, thanks, Rashmita. Thanks for starting the session in the brief introduction. So let me share my screen and let's start this. Okay. So thank you again for joining all and investing your time in a working day. So today I'm going to talk about extending Microsoft Viva Connections with SPFx along with how to set up the home site and what are the different options available when we are thinking about the Viva Connections setting up with SPFx and other components available in Microsoft Viva. So before I jump into that, I just wanted to briefly give you my introduction. So myself, Kirti Prajapati, and I'm modern workplace consultant as well as working as SharePoint architect in Microsoft MVP and MCT. And along with this, I'm more interested in Microsoft 365 and SharePoint and Office development component, which includes like anything Microsoft Teams apps, then custom web parts, then integration with Microsoft using Power Platform, anything. Along with this, I'm also a speaker where I'm sharing my thoughts and knowledge wherever the possibility available, like it could be a kind of local event or the international event. And I have my own blog site where I can also provide some kind of knowledge where I come across with some issues in the project and then sharing my knowledge and someone may get help from there. And also providing corporate training. And along with this, in terms of community sharing, so I am an organizer of Microsoft 365 Ahmedabad user group in Gujarat, where under this user group's umbrella, we are organizing workshops and in-person events and online events where we can help the local community and grow the community in a better way. So if you want to get in touch with me, then you can see my social media information is also there along with the email address, so we can be in touch through that platform. So before we start today's session, so this is the brief agenda I prepared for today's session. So we'll introduce like what is Microsoft Viva and what is Microsoft Viva Connections and how you can set up this Viva Connections. And after setting up, if you want to extend it, then what are the capabilities you have using SharePoint Framework? So these 4 points I'll try to cover in this next 45 or 50 minutes. And also I will more focus on the demo. So theoretical like introduction part will be a kind of basic information, but most important thing is how to set it up, then how to create the web part and extend into your home site as well as the Microsoft Teams. So let's start with first Microsoft Viva. As you know that Microsoft Viva is the company's latest offering from Microsoft, which has become a topic of interest among organizations. So most of the organizations are looking out for Viva implementation for now, but most of the companies or the person who don't know about that, then they might have question, what is Microsoft Viva and how it can help their companies? Is it a part of Microsoft 365? So they might have a lot of questions before implementing this Microsoft Viva. So according to Microsoft, Viva is an employee experience platform with functionalities to bring learning, insights, communications, and resource together on one platform. So everything comes on one platform, so that will be very easy for an organization to adopt it. And it is powered by Microsoft 365, and all the companies can experience it via Microsoft Teams as well. It is not restricted that if you have implemented home site for this Viva connection, then it is only available for the SharePoint site. No, but you can also experience the same in Microsoft Teams. So basically, Microsoft Viva spans for in four categories. You can see I have mentioned four categories, that connections, learning, insights, and topics. So in this session, we are more focusing on the connections. We will not discuss about the learning, insights, and topics. So what is connections? So Microsoft Viva connections offer innovative engagement experience, which can help you to keep everyone in the team informed. So no one miss any information which is rolled out throughout the company. And using artificial intelligence, Microsoft Viva fosters fruitful engagement in the workplace. So everyone can get what has been announced in the company. And it also provides a gateway into company resources. Let's say, for example, if you have some information from the HR department and the other policies regarding this recruitment, so they can get from the same place. Furthermore, it also allows employees to participate in business processes and communities effectively. So there are a lot of options. They can communicate with each other and be an active participant throughout the organizations. So Viva Connections also shows in apps you are currently using. For example, as I mentioned that you will have the same experience in Microsoft Teams. So if you are using Viva Connections, then it also shows in apps like Microsoft Teams. And it is also tailored specifically for each user. So all users who are accessing the Microsoft Teams in organization, they can access that app from Microsoft Teams. And the users get a company branded experience or whatever they like, look and feel or branding you have done for the site, and also getting access to digital resources and organizational tools. Right. So this is just basic, like how Viva Connection can be used, and it can help you. It can help your employees. So Viva Connection is powered by SharePoint. So the first question, like how it can be like useful, how can business use Microsoft Viva, right? Business, what are the different options available when we talk about the business? So now you know that Microsoft Viva definition. So business can use in a different way. So if you consider then in the previous days when companies could overlook their employees' engagement and health, today it is more important to focus on employee engagement and experience if you want to success in the market. So that's the most prioritized task for the organization, that they can balance this experience. So owing to the digitization of most processes, especially like during this COVID pandemic, it has become even more imperative to offer a good digital employee experience where if you want to generate considerable revenue and grow your business during this kind of pandemic time. So fortunately, we have the Microsoft Viva, and that offers an employee experience ecosystem where you can combine learning programs with collaborations to ensure your workforce ultimate satisfaction and engagement. So they will come to know like what has been announced, and they will get all the real-time information from one platform only. And along with this, that is basically used to improve employee experience as well. So if you think, most employers think their employees leave because they are getting better money somewhere else, right? But most of the time, the reality is quite different. only around 10 to 15% leave due to money, while others quite due to poor experiences in the workplace. So nowadays, that is most important, that how you are managing the employees in terms of experience in the workplace. So keeping that in mind, it is integral to give your employees a good working experience so that they stay loyal to the organization. And Microsoft Viva offers many features to help to accomplish this functionality. Let's say, for example, Viva Topics. So Viva Topic is used to ensure your employees are not frustrated due to the excessive time it takes them to find relevant information. So sometimes what happens, like in the company, someone is looking out for some information, but they don't find anything by asking different set of people or by searching somewhere else. So Microsoft Viva Topics comes into the picture, where we have a kind of knowledge repository, and from there anyone can get all the information available, relevant information available there. So Topics organizes all related information in one place, and it makes your employees' lives easier. So they can get all the information from one place only. And second thing is like Viva Insights. So it also gives an overview of employee happiness and provides mindfulness opportunities through headspace integration. So therefore, it will ensure that your employees are not only physically well, but also mentally healthy. Right, so that is also coming, like most of the time you are also receiving emails regarding your this kind of mental health and physical wellness from the Viva. So it offers the different advantages in the long run. Like, for example, it can offer a better working experience to employees, and it also prevent burnout time when we are spending more times in workspace. And it will also boost the productivity and prioritize mental health. So that in this way, that can help us to improve employee experience. And then some of the cases will help in the driving the business decisions. So like, for example, companies make big employee related business decisions. For example, you can use the insights to determine the improvements needed in the onboarding process. So that is one scenario we can think about, like they can check that onboarding process, and they can identify like what are the pros and what process needs to be corrected. So that can be a kind of good business scenario where they can think about the business decision. And then we have the enhanced employee engagement. So it is possible that a study shows that nearly around 30 to 40% workforce is engaged in the workplace, and that's less than half maybe. So while it may not sound alarming at first, employee disengagement actually causes companies a significant financial loss. So this way we can also engage employees, and we can also enhance this engagement throughout the organization. So as a conclusion, we can say that Microsoft Viva has the potential to become the next big thing in improving employee experience. Business should employ it in their day-to-day tasks to make sure employees can learn, connect, and collaborate effectively. And moreover, the insights feature allows managers and team leaders to oversee employee performance and make required improvements. So these are the different scenarios we can consider, which can help us to improve when we are talking about Microsoft Viva Connections. Now, whenever we are trying to implement this Viva connection, so I have just come across this image from Microsoft site, that these are the different eight steps we have to follow to set up Microsoft Viva connections. So the first is we have to prepare our intranet, where you can create your site, new site, or you can also use the existing site. And in second step, we have to set that site as a home site. So in one tenant, we only one site could be a home site. So I'll show you that how to create it and how to set it up as a home site. Then after we have to enable the app bar. So after enabling app bar, we will be able to see this create a dashboard option, from where we can create a dashboard along with different cards and some of the permissions, who can see the cards, like target audiencing and everything. And then in the fifth step, we can also prepare the content for the feed, like whatever the content you are looking to announce in that dashboard. And then after, we can add this app into Microsoft Teams. So from Microsoft Teams, everyone can open that home site and they will be able to see the dashboard. And then you can launch with end users. So all the end users can get all the information from this one. So these steps I'll show you in the demo. And then we will extend with the out-of-the-box functionality with one of the SharePoint framework web part. So let me jump into demo directly. So in the first step, as I was mentioning, that we have to have one home site. So for that, what you have to do, like, you can just log in into your tenant and go to your SharePoint admin center. So I have just opened that just to save the time. So this is my Microsoft 365 admin center, and this is my SharePoint admin center. So from here, you can check that under the settings, we have these options available. So here you can see home site. So first you have to check if your SharePoint admin center enable with any home site or not. If you don't have any home site, then this text box will be blank. So now we are trying to create one home site. So as I mentioned, that you can create new site or use the existing site as home site, but I just wanted to make sure that the whatever the site we are creating, it will look like a proper user interface, and some default content will be available. So for that, I'm just trying to use this lookbook.microsoft.com, where you can see different set of templates available. So if you click on this URL, you will be able to see this site. And from here, you can see all available templates. So I'm just clicking on this see examples, and then we'll have this seven categorized templates available. So for organization, we have this much of templates available. So you can use any one as per your interest and as per your requirement, like what type of content you are trying to have in that site. So you can pick anything, like for example, if I'm just picking this this one, new video, and this. So here it will ask, like, this template you want to add into your tenant. So once you click on this add to your tenant, it will ask you the tenant URL, then site name, site URL. So that information you have to fill in. So here you can see I'm logged in with this tenant, SP console 365. So it automatically gets this email address. Then this is the site title. You can also change it from here. Then this will be the site URL if you want to change it in any case. And then we have to click on the provision. Now, when you click on provision, it will take around 10 to 15 minutes to provision this template into your tenant. And then you will be able to see the site has been created. Right, so just to save the time, I have already created one site just before this session. So you can see global sales is my site which I have created using the sales template. So I'm just trying to open this here. So it will have all the content which comes under that template. So you can see that this is the default site created with the content, and different web parts are also there. So this way you will be able to see that how the site will be created in a shorter time. Then from here, now we have to move it to the second step, that once your site is created, now I want to promote this site as a home site. So just copy this URL and go to your SharePoint admin center. And from there, when you click on home site, this box will be available where you have to paste this URL. and then it will validate, okay, this site can be set as your home site, and then save it. So once your site is saved as a home site, you will be able to set like Viva connections and everything then. Now, let me see if we can see that. So here you can see we under these settings, we don't have the global navigation option here, right? Because I have not refreshed yet, though I just added that as a home site. So I'm just refreshing this and we will be able to see that global navigation options then. So let's see. Yeah, so once you add that URL as a home site, then and then you will be able to see this global navigation option. And then this is the setup Viva connection. So these two options will not be available for normal site, right? We have to promote any site as a home site, and then you will be able to see these two different options from where we can set up a Viva connections route. Now we'll first enable this global navbar. So let's click on that. Global navigation. Yeah. So here it is off. So we just have to turn on. And then you can change the logo if you want. So here you can upload the logo. You can also change the title. Then in the navigation source, you can specify that home site or the hub or global navigation. So let's keep it as is. We do not need to change anything for this demo. But yes, you can do whatever the changes you are looking for from this right side panel. And then you can click on save. So we have just done that global navigation setup as it is. We are not changing anything. And then we'll set up this Viva connections. So just click on this settings and then from setup Viva connections. So here we are just setting for the first time, so we have to create the dashboard, right? So it will create an interactive experience for organizations, mobile app where we can add the cards and some kind of web content in this app. So let's click on the create dashboard, and then it will allow us to create the, this will be in a kind of mobile view. So here you can see, on top left corner, we have the options like which mode you want to use, mobile or desktop. So by default it opens in a mobile, but let's click on desktop. So here we have that option. So start a building. So let's add card. Then click on this one. So here you can see we have seven out of the box options available where you can create some kind of approvals card. Then if you want to create a dashboard card that shows the preview of the assigned task, then you can use this. Then if you want to use the this template for card designer, you can also use it. You can use the shift for the scheduling. Then if you want to use any Microsoft Teams app, then you can use this one. And if you want to display the this news, SharePoint news, then you can use this news one. And if you just want to use the web links or kind of URL where from where user can redirect from one place to another, then you can use that. So let's say if I'm just clicking on this web link and I'm just trying to add a couple of web link. So here from this property pane, you can change the card information, card properties as well. Let's say, for example, what type of size you want for the card. So this will be the larger side of this card, and by default, it's medium. And if you want to give any link, then you can provide the link. In card description, you can, if you want that. So see here, I have just passed my spconsole.com URL, and you can see that that is rendering in the card itself, like the home page of the portal. And it also gets some the text from the page itself. So that is the beauty of this. You can check like on the fly how it will look like in the card. And if I change the size from medium to large, it will look like this. So here you can check link, image, the banner, and that text on the site. And if you want to change the image, then you can also select from the custom image. And then you can also use a different set of card icons, that custom image, auto selected, or any icon you want to change it. And if you want to use audiences to target, you can just give 50 audience limit for this specific web link. So that is also available here. So let's go with another one. Then we can just click on assign task. Then it will ask us to implement or add some properties for this task as well. So assign task, let's say, for example, I'm just keeping my name. Or we can just keep as is assigned task list for now. And once you are ready, so for this, for demo purpose, I'm just using two cards, but you can use as much as you want. Like we have seven options, so out of seven you can use any. Let's say use these top news, right? So once you are satisfied with like how your dashboard will look like, then you can just publish this. So I'm just clicking on the publish. So yeah, we are good. Now we are done with this, and then the other step is home site, enable app bar, create a dashboard, prepare the content. Now we are in the sixth step, where we have to add the app in Microsoft Teams. So for that, you have to go to your Teams admin. So I'm just jumping into that from Microsoft 365 Admin Center. From the left navigation admin centers, you can just click on Teams. Then from here, you have to open the Teams apps, and you have to manage the application. So that once this is open in the left side navigation, we will have a option called Teams app, from where we can manage the apps, and we will search for the Viva Connections. So Teams apps, then manage apps. And here we just need to search with Viva Connections. So here I am searching. You can see the Viva Connections is there. This is blocked by publisher. So let's click on that if that allows, and click on allow. Yeah, app status was changed, then it is allowed now. So under the actions, from here we can see under this action, we can just customize it. And from here you can change these names, like right? Same property, like whatever the changes you want to, like if you want to change this icon, you can change it from here. If you want to change the theme, color, everything can be changed from here. But this is just for your information, that once you are like allowing this Viva Connections to be used in your Teams, then you can change these property accordingly. So I'm not doing any change for this as of now. I'm just clicking close. And now we have to check this for the this personal app for settings. So for that, we can just keep these setup policies. Then from setup policies, we have to check this global organization wide default. And then we have to pin that, check this, if this is not available here. So we can just click on add apps and search for the Viva connections. So here we have that, click on add, and that will be available in under our Teams app. So you can change the sequence if you want. Like I want to have that as the first rank. So I'm just using this. And then we are all good. Then clicking on save. And meanwhile, I'm just opening these Teams as well. So I am using this Teams browser. So you will be able to see that Microsoft Viva Connections will be the first option in the left navigation. And when I click on that, it will open the same look and feel site as we have the global sales. This one. And yeah, on the home page, so we have created the dashboard, right? So let's add that on the home page. So click on edit. Go to the page wherever you want to add that dashboard. So basically, generally most of the time we are having all the important information on the home page. So I am just using that home page, and adding this here. I'm just adding one more section on top of this banner and just clicking on this. And see here, if you type with dashboard, then you will be able to see the dashboard for Viva Connections. So once I click on that, I will be able to see all three cards which we have created in that dashboard. So from here, your employee will be able to see everything, like the most important thing which you want that each and every employee should know about, right? Now I'm not republishing this, so it means we should not have that in this Viva connection. So in these Teams, you see in the left navigation, Viva connections is the first one. So if I click on that, I will not be able to see that dashboard as of now because I have not published that page, right? So let's do that. Come to this page, then republish it, and then refresh this page in Microsoft Teams. So it will have the same user experience at both the places, in your SharePoint site as well as in Microsoft Teams. So this is how you will be having a common platform where user will get all the information which has been shared with using Viva connections, right? Now, this is the out of the box thing, but most of the time, we may have a different set of requirement which is not fulfilled using this out of the box option. Let's say, for example, if I go to the dashboard, then I might not have this one. Let's go to that view dashboard. So I'm just editing this page. Desktop, and I want a custom web part where I want to display something from my SharePoint list, right? So here we don't have that capability that you can use this out of the box dashboards and get all the information. So what we can do, like then we have the SharePoint framework which can help us to extend this Microsoft Viva connections as per our requirement. So just to save the time, I have already created one web part which is in another tenant. So I am opening that tenant in Firefox. So you can see this is the site which is a home site, and I have enabled this Viva connections here. And this, on top of this, you can see one web part I have created, and this web part is retrieving all these values, the title and description, from one of the SharePoint list. So that list is this announcements. where I have two entries, and I have made a logic like the important. I have a column called important. So let's say, for example, if you want that something is highlighted to all the users when someone opens the site, and they will come to know, okay, this is highlighted, so this is important news for us or important announcements for us to look into. So I have created one list where I have a column called important, and if it is true, then it will display that title in a red color. So this is just a sample, but you can have different set of logic or different set of requirement, and you can implement in such a way. So for that, I have created a SharePoint framework web part. So just to save the time, I also created that solution. So solution is basic, like what we are creating using the SPFx yo command. But here you need to keep in mind that if you want to use Microsoft Viva Connections, then your SPFx version would be 1.13 or greater than that. Like, it will not allow, or we don't have that functionality to create those web parts, these web parts in the previous version. So if I'm just using this, I'm just trying to create a couple of wanted to give brief. So just walk you through about the steps. That's the basic steps which we have in this while we are creating any web part. So I'm just moving to my specific library. So I have this demo folder here, so I'm just creating another folder called demo1 and just going into that. And you have to use this same command, Microsoft and then it will prompt you for some of the information, like what is the solution name and description. So I'm just keeping as is for now, just to walk you through about the steps. And then use only online, then use the current folder. Then we are not allowing this, so I'm just clicking no. And will this component solution required? No. Here we are using web part, so I'm just selecting the web part, and web part name is the default one, description same is, and here I have not used any React framework, so I'll go with the no JavaScript framework, and then this will take like 4-5 minutes to scaffold your project, and once this project is scaffolded, then you can register your certificates like using gulp trust dev cert command. And then you can update the code accordingly, like what logic you are looking out for. So for now, meanwhile, this is scaffolding the solution. I am just opening the solution which I have already created. So in the render method of this webpart.ts file, you have to apply the user interface or the UI, like what type of UI you are looking out for your component, right? So here I have just designed that. And basic logic is it is getting this all the information from my announcement list with these three columns, title, description, and important, and it is displaying here in this format, right? And here also I'm just adding this CSS style where if my important column is selected as yes, then it will have the different set of color in which is I have added into this CSS file. So if you can see that, so that also access this this important. So dot important will have the red color. So for title, it will get red color if the value of that important field is yes. right? And yeah, so that's it from for the code part. But yes, you can have like a code as per your logic, and it will have the same approach which we are using for the SharePoint framework web part development. So once you are done with your this web part development, then you can also check in this local workbench using this gulp, so no browser command. And once you are satisfied with the HTML, the user interface rendering, everything, then you can deploy the same solution using the same command, like publish and package the solution, and you can drag and drop into your app catalog. So once it is available in the app catalog, then you can have that in your web part gallery. So if you click on the edit page, and then you will be able to see from this gallery, web part galleries, that you can add that web parts. So here, so you can see the company announcements web parts. So I'm just adding again. So just let's refresh the list, and we will try to remove this red color by unchecking that important field value. So I'm just unchecking this. Important field is no. And save this. And just refreshing this page. Right, so we have that color code gone for this first record, and the same look and feel you will be having in your Microsoft Teams. So I'm just refreshing the Teams, and it will have the same user interface look and feel in your this Teams home site homepage as well. Right, so yeah, this way we can use SPFx and extend the capabilities, like whatever the out of the box component we have. But as per our requirement, we can change that in code and apply the logic and get that done for a specific solution. So I think we are almost done. And then, yeah, once your app is available in this Microsoft Teams, then you will be able to share that with the users, and they can just log in into that, and they can pin wherever they want. Like in our case, in this case, I am using this personal app. I have just pinned it for at one first place, so they can also use that and pin and unpin from their interface. So this is how they will be able to have that link in their Microsoft Teams. And once they click on that, they will be able to see the same user experience in Microsoft Teams as well. Yeah, so I think that's it from my end for today's session. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions, and then we have few more minutes so we can discuss on that. If you don't have any questions, if you have any suggestions, I am happy to have all the suggestions and your input.
Hello. Yeah. How about the multi-language?
Yes, multi-language, we can use that. But for that, I think we have to use the resource file concept in web part. Are you talking about the web part, right?
Yes.
Yes. So we have that capability where we have different options, like you can use the resource file as well as the multilingual components. Yeah, but that is possible. Yes, that's possible.
And how about the whole site?
Whole site. From website, so from web part, it is not possible, but that will be a kind of website configuration, not the web page or the web part configuration.
Okay. Thank you.
And Vikram, no, we cannot enable more than one home site. No, because see, if I open this in my SharePoint admin center, we have only one option here. You can see SharePoint default admin center one, home site one, notification pages. So here if I click, then we just have two options, just check or uncheck. The same way, if we go with the home site, then we will have only one option. Either you can remove this and enable another site as a home site. So that's the one option we only have. And the version which Viva Connections supports is 1.13 or above, like 1.14, 15. So it will not work with 1.10, 11 or 12. So make sure that you have the upgraded version for SPFx web parts. Anyone have any questions? Okay. So Sahil is asking like, we are using SPFx web part in customization. So as I mentioned, let me show you that again. So when we are creating the dashboard, if I go there, set up Viva Connections and then view dashboard. So it may happen that the option you are looking out to share with all the employee throughout the organization is not available here as a card. Like if I edit this web part, clicking on add a card. So here we see only seven options. We do have seven options, right? We do not have any kind of customization thing. So if you want to implement such requirement, then we have to use the let me reshare the screen. Okay, so here if you can see, when you are clicking on this add a card, we only have seven options available. But when SPFx comes into the picture, that if this out of seven options you do not have any option matching with your requirement, then you can come up with SPFx solution where you will have all the capabilities or the functionalities you want to share with users. So in that way, we are extending this capabilities using SPFx. That's the title of this session. So, but before that, we should have this Viva Connections set up, and from there we can take it further, like what type of functionality you want to achieve, which is not available out of the box in the dashboard. And then you want to put your own component here, and then you can add that component on different page and user can access from website as well as the Microsoft Teams experience. So yeah, that's the reason that we have to use. SPFx. Yes, yes, it can be created in React. But just for the simplicity, I have used this no JavaScript framework. Not necessarily, it depends like what version you are trying to use, and according to you have this compatible version for Gulp as well as the Node.js. It will automatically ask you like it is not compatible, or you can check from the Microsoft site that you will have that options, like which version is supported with the compatibility in terms of Node.js as well as Gulp serve, Gulp command. Yeah, Rasmita, I think we are good. Let me know if anyone have any questions.
Sure.
Or you can also connect with me on my social media. Let me share that again, so we can be in touch. If in case you need more information while you are implementing that, then we can connect through that social media information. So you can just connect with me LinkedIn, Twitter, or you can send me an email on my personal email address. I will be more than happy to connect with you and
if there is no more question, then we would like to wrap up today's session. Thank you, Kirti, so much for today's session, and thank you all for joining us today. Let me just share my screen. You'll be able to see today's learn module link. I've already shared in the chat as well. Please access this link. It will give you additional resources to take your learning further. Also, please visit our Microsoft Reactor Bengaluru meetup page for more upcoming session. Thank you all once again and enjoy the rest of your day.